Hi there, and thanks for joining us here on the web. I'm Erin Phalo. One person is dead after a violent crash on Route 101 in Candia this morning. You can see the car up an embankment next to a bridge. Traffic was backed up for miles for several hours. This happened just as the morning commute was starting to pick up. There was a lot of fog, but police say the weather had nothing to do with the crash. Ray Brewer reports.
The call came in just as morning rush hour was getting underway. At 7:10 this morning, New Hampshire State Police say they got a report of a car at the Chester Turnpike Bridge over 101 in Candia.
The first reports came in that the car actually came off the bridge, but that's not what happened.
By tracing the tire marks in the snow, state police say it's fairly easy to determine what happened, but not why. As the car headed eastbound on 101, the driver left the highway.
Sharply veered off to the right, traveled up the grass shoulder before striking the bridge.
The driver was killed in the head-on crash. State police say he is a local man in his 50s. The accident backed up traffic for miles in both directions as the accident reconstruction team looked for an explanation. As far as the road conditions, state police say that does not appear to have been a factor.
The roads were wet, but not freezing over. That's my understanding.
State police say they are looking for witnesses, even as they try to determine if there was anything mechanically wrong with the car.
We'll put the vehicle inside, and the members of that team will be looking through the vehicle and checking the black box, etc.
A developing story now from the seacoast. Three children under the age of two left alone inside an apartment. And now Portsmouth police are looking for the fiancé of the father of those children. Investigators say this woman, 25-year-old Miranda Reifenberg, sent her fiancé a text message saying she was leaving him and his children. The father rushed home and found his kids all alone inside. He says that Reifenberg took all of her belongings with her. She's wanted on three counts of endangering the welfare of a minor. Police say that she does not have a vehicle or any strong ties to the area. If you see her, call the Seacoast Crime Stoppers at 431-1199. Manchester police say two men robbing a home on Hall Street dove through a closed window trying to get away from officers. Police responded to the home after a PS&H worker reported seeing two men acting suspiciously. 18-year-old Nathan Cashman of Manchester and 25-year-old Patrick Keogh were arrested and charged with burglary and resisting arrest. Investigators say Cashman was also involved with a burglary earlier this month on Russell Street, where two guns were stolen, as well as jewelry and electronics. Well, starting tonight at 5, the largest wireless carrier posts a stunning loss, in part because of the iPhone. Verizon says it lost about $2 billion. Why its highly anticipated contract to offer iPhones is partly to blame. That does it for us. Thanks for joining us, and do have a great afternoon.